even if you can only be here for a few hours, that anything will help, just so we can kind of shuffle you around, make sure the kids are all doing what they're supposed to, and they don't miss anything. Does anybody have any symposium questions? Yes.
I don't have a question, but
okay.
So I inspired my coffee and put in for the hospital.
Okay.
So if anybody does coffee, I'm not doing coffee.
I have a coffee maker and I have filters.
What about our
you'll have a carafe.
Well, I want to borrow the carafe, but I don't make the coffee.
Oh, we can make it.
Okay.
I
Googled it when we did it for the kindergarten breakfast. I had to Google how much to put
in. And Natasha said she didn't make coffee. She just buys coffee.
I can K-cup all day, but the.
So if somebody wants to volunteer,
Texas would be nice. I just dump it in the eyeball.
So we could just make it here and bring it out.
Can we just make it out there? Do we have an extension cord? We can just make it out there.
I don't know where.
You have a couple of carafes too. We can just maybe make it in here and then bring the carafes out. Uh-huh. You bring some.
Or two with pump pots.
Do we have coffee or do we need to buy coffee?
I don't know who usually does that.
I never
did that part.
Well, it was always Missy, and she just did her own little thing. I can add it. I have to do paperwork for a few other things, so I can add the coffee too.
Home bank can donate some coffee. I'll send it with Sam tomorrow.
Hey!
You're welcome.
You can just send it to have him bring to the office since we'll make it in the front.
Okay.
Perfect. We'll thank you.
Yay! Mm-hmm. That's fun. Problem solving. I like it. Anybody else? Okay. I promise I'm not panicking. all right. Appreciation committee. Rochelle, you want to come do the recap from the conference part?
Sure. Enough left over. I think the next day also a lot of drinks left over for sure. And we have our next one is mid-December, the 12th, 13th, something like that. I'll send something out closer to that time to get some more volunteers and more donations. And we do need somebody to take over the committee if anybody's interested. So spread the word if anybody would like to take over a conference card. And closer to Mardi Gras, we'll have our King Cake Day for the teachers, and we also have a luncheon in May. So if you're interested, talk to me or Randy and just let us know.
Those are pretty rewarding volunteer opportunities that you can do mostly from home. You make a sign-up sheet, and usually I come like after work, after school, organize, clean up, tidy, make sure it's all available, push a cart, and that's it. So there's not a lot of, it's not a huge time commitment for the sign-ups and the delivery. Those are ones that are fun to do for them.
And you get to meet all the teachers if you don't know them yet, and the kids like to come with us and be a part of it.
It's nice to be associated with them.
Yeah. And we like to thank our teachers and take care of them. They take care of our children every day, so we want to take care of them too. Right. Any questions about conference card or teacher appreciation or anything? No? Easy crowd?
Yeah. All right. So, new business. Matching funds requests. I can take this unless you have anything you want to just holler at me if I miss anything. October 11th, the school board voted and approved that parent committees could apply for matching funds for grounds improvement.
It's not
any school?
Any school
money. Got it. Okay.
Yes.
So
any organization, whether it be the school or PTC or baseball or football or
so any fundraising to do with the school. Mm-hmm. Okay. And so we had some idea that was coming, so we were a little prepared, although we did have to submit the paperwork by last Friday, and then we had more stuff that's going out this week, so it's all moving very quickly. You wanted to say the numbers because I've already forgotten them for what we've asked for, or is that... Not yet.
Well, we had budgeted $14,500 for playground this year, and the general fund membership approved that. So we're asking for them to match the $14,500, and we'll try. try to see about last year.
Yeah.
But, so we'll see what happens. Yeah. But anything's better than nothing.
Yes. And so the goal is, obviously, we have this big new playground, and it's awesome, but we didn't want to stop there. So anything that we can do every year to contribute more and more to the playground and to the grounds, we want to do. So that's the goal. Awesome. Any questions? All right, and then patriotic ceremony is coming up next month.
Yes.
That's Jennifer, that's all you.
Can I do it from here?
Yes.
All right. Patriotic Day is November 11th. Nope, it's the 10th.
Yeah.
The 11th is the Saturday. Everybody should have gotten one of these home that explains what it does and everything. What PTC usually does is, and I'll have Brandy help me do a time to sign up because I have no idea.
Yep.
Is the drinks for our heroes. We usually do coffee, orange juice, milk, and bottled water because it is usually still hot. I would also like some help setting up the Thursday evening before, if anybody wants to volunteer to help me out. I just need one or two people. And then the day of, I need someone to help corral the scouts, because the boys and the Girl Scouts get to wear their uniforms, and they have a special place of honor that they get to stand, and corralling them is a more than one person job. But I'm very excited. I got off the phone with Ms. Bollinger earlier, and she's also very excited to celebrate our heroes at Woodvale.
We talked about not vaccinating today.
Do we, I know the first time I saw the patriotic ceremony, I had no idea that it was such a big deal. Do you want to explain a little bit? I know we have some new parents.
Patriotic Day is, we ask our students to bring in first responders, any former veterans, anybody active in the military, and it's just a day to say thank you. We give them coffee and breakfast and snacks. The teachers bring in food, breakfast items, and they always spoil us. But it's just to say thank you for all our hard-working Woodvale heroes.
And it is an actual ceremony.
Yes.
Like, every name is called, and they walk, and it's very, very special.
So.
Mm-hmm. I took pictures last year, and there's one of each to each veteran.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
nice.
Often to the general, yeah.
I had a question. Why is there not a flag on the flagpole?
I don't know the answer to that one. Okay. Anybody have any questions? Another question. I'll walk in. Okay. All right. So we're done with PTC stuff. Unless anybody has anything else, the World Series starts at 7:09. For those of you who are Astros fans, I'm watching the clock, I'm ready. So I was good with.
This is not really part of the show, but I just wanted to tell everyone that we're about to start our fall fundraiser that we did for Woodvale, and that's going to start next Monday, October 30th, the kickoff, and then it's going to go through November 16th,
okay,
or before the Thanksgiving break.
Yes.
We'll give y'all more info on that next week.
Yeah, and I want to thank Hannah Mason and Jessica, the mayor. They're both going to run our fall fundraiser for Woodvale.
Yes.
Thank you both.
No hits. We're not
going to
find out what it is.
I know.
Oh. Okay, it's something we have done before. It's really basically the inflated mug, and some with Woodville on it, but then a lot of other food items.
Cookie dough.
And is there wrapping paper? Not this year? Online. Okay.
Questions? I have a question about room parents. teacher favorites.
Yes.
So I went to look for my child and other teachers' favorites, and it's not attached to my phone. Do you know anything about it?
I do know that there's a binder with all of the responses we've gotten so far in the workroom. So that's
I don't know, Denise has sent it out.
Yeah, she just sent
it out.
Right.
All the teachers
and so we were missing.
Because my only got fourth grade, so I don't know if she just gave it. Like, I just got fourth grade because I'm only fourth grade. I don't know. But in the past, we always had everybody.
Right.
Because, like, you know,
Denise said she probably.
Yeah. Okay. For sure, though, they are printed. So you can always find them. It's a binder. It's got big red letters on it. It says Woodvale teacher favorites. They should be alphabetized. So I know we were still missing some at the end of last week. It's in the workroom. There's a little milk carton box. It's all the PTC stuff in it. Mm-hmm. It's right in there. Sticking up because it's too big to fit in.
Did you check the Reminds app in the
That's the one I only
in
yeah. Yeah. It's not in there.
Yeah, all I got
my it's not in there.
Second grade.
That would be Denise.
And our teacher was not in there.
Okay. Yeah, so we did. Yeah. We definitely were missing some teachers still at the end of last week. So we're working on getting all of the rest of those. And I'll see if we can find a way to do all the spreadsheets through the Reminds so that okay. They're all...
Is that for Christmas presents? Or what?
Yeah, or Christmas presents, birthdays.
Teacher
yeah.
appreciation.
Like, some of us, like, when we're up at school, like, we know, like, our old teacher's favorite drink, we'll just stop by and give it to her.
Okay. So, and as a room parent, I can email the other parents and
yes.
share that and yes. just say, okay, yes. this is her birthday, this is for Christmas.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, and so... Yeah.
With your kids to school.
Okay.
And put your name on the envelope and ask them to donate extra money. So okay. you can buy them a
gift. Okay.
And you'd get a card and have all the kids on it before you give it to them.
Oh, that's good.
There's a lot of really fun things. And yeah. some of the questions are geared towards gifts, and some of them are just fun, like get to know you questions, like how many pets do you have? And
okay.
What are your initials if you wanted something monogrammed? But we'll see about, like I said, for sure they're printed, they're alphabetized, they're in the workroom, but we'll work on getting the big full spreadsheet to everybody, so that, because like, there's other faculty too that have filled them out, not mm-hmm. just teachers, so librarians, and I think last year for sure I got some from cafeteria.
Well, I had actually clarified that with Denise a couple days ago. I know she wanted to send that all the staff members too, and the office, right. and like all the paraprofessionals. Part of
yep.
the school that makes it fun. So
yep.
she said absolutely send that to everybody. So you might be getting an influx of
perfect. More. So it's nice to have, if we have all the information, if everybody has it all, we'll find stuff and say thanks in different ways.
Because you never know, like, I might be working with somebody else or something. Okay. Teacher. That's what I just wanted to give it, bring a drink. I didn't know what you wanted.
So do we have time for any teachers want to share anything about leader meeting? Just in kindergarten, Christy Bashaw, kindergarten teacher. I know with ours, we're introducing it to us, but it's cute because now they'll come back to school and they talk about it. They go out to recess and say they, you know, we were thinking win-win outside where I did this first and then I did what my friend wanted. Or we hear a lot of work first then play when they go home to do their homework and then they do. So it's been cute to hear how they come in and talk about it. And how they synergize at center time to pick up and put things away. So it's been really cute to see how they're using all the seven habits and getting it. And they are, they're getting it. So it's really cute.
I'm Lauren Guillory. I'm a fourth grade teacher. We've been really using like the synergize habit. Our science this year is like so hands-on, which is great. And we have kids that are coming from so many different schools this year. So they're working together with new people that they haven't seen years before. And we've been using our Chromebooks to do a web quest. So they're learning their science, they're learning how to use Chromebooks, they're learning how to find things on different websites, and they really are getting better each day with synergizing. So it's great to see them just working together to get one task done as a group. So we're doing in fourth grade.
I'm Anna Kettinger, I'm second grade. We've been really focusing on our school-wide WIGS, which is the wildly important goal that every student in the school is working towards the same big goal, but in their own way. So we've been working a lot with math, fact, fluency, and reaching their AR goal. And it's fun to see them track it in the classroom and watch their their little goal grow, and they encourage each other. And like when our whole class made their AR goal, we went on one student to bring up her average when she did it. I mean, we were all so excited for her and for the class because we all did it. So they really are getting this goal setting and working and knowing that they're part of a bigger picture too, of filling their class and their grade and their school.
Well, we were proactive. I'm Melody Gullett, one of the PE teachers, and we were proactive this year. And we taught line dancing before the Boo Bash. And for the Boo Bash, it ended up being a big hit. Last year, Miss B said that a lot of the kids didn't know what to do. They turned on the music. And so this year, they actually were participating and actually asking me, well, we're going to dance, we're going to dance. So it kind of made me excited, you know, that they were applying and doing what we did.
The macaroni.
She's on the team that does a lot of our school-wide jobs. Did you want to share anything?
We have ambassadors for the school. You can go into that, Ms. Rina, if you like. Okay. We've just recently picked most of our school-wide jobs. We still have school photographers to get. We added that job recently. So those students will be taking time out to take pictures at the symposium and the big grand ceremony. So hopefully Ms. Rizzo has some chosen support symposium. We picked things like the door holders. We have a cafeteria leader in practice duty. We have tour guides, ambassadors, and those ambassadors are really great people for things like the patriotic ceremony. We have some in third and some in fourth. Most of the jobs go to the fourth grade, but we do have some jobs that begin in third to try to get them a little more responsibility. And I'm forgetting Melody. So we have cafeteria leaders, we have door holders, there's two or three students that turn on the computers, get them set up for the kids who go in there for interventions, and also for today. They also, I think a couple of them go in there in the evening. They're all closing down. Most of them go in the morning for sure. We have seven. And then there's an office person. We have two office liaisons as well, and an office person that leader that go in there, and the office leader gets the technology ready for the morning in the front office, and the two office liaisons go in there and just run general things that they might need done. They could be stapling, they could be sorting papers, they could be running things to classrooms that parents have dropped off. They could be helping a kindergartner find their place to be, things like that. So we have a lot of different jobs this year. We're always open to suggestions, so if you have some ideas and ways that kids could become leaders, because the more jobs we open up, the more responsibility that some kids can have. And I know that photographer, there's three or four of those jobs, those are going to be coveted positions.
Yeah, I think we have a class set of cameras that Ms. Spencer had applied for a grant, and so they were passed down to, I think, Ms. Weber's class, and she's allowing the photographers to use the class set of cameras and their digital cameras. So they walk around with their little red cameras. And I think Ms. Rizzo said she was going to make a press badge for them. And all of them.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
Yeah.
I'll
have credentials.
So again, all of that is just real sensitive of leader information.
Just wanted to kind of share that. On my reveal, I have VI, visually impaired, and blind students. And so I have an opportunity that a lot of the regular ed teachers don't have. I get to see the students at all levels. So we have kindergarten. forth. So we can, I can see the changes when you're first learning the leader in me, and they're trying to learn the songs and the motions, and they're learning how to do all their things. And then, you know, the next year, they're moving into doing their notebooks and sharing and things, and I can see them advance, you know, until they get into fourth grade, and they have it all down. They can tell you all about all of the parts of the leader in me and the purpose of their leader in me books, and they know what they need to do every day to record it. And we try to get them to use all of the habits when they can. And what I'm finding is happening, they're noticing when they do something and say, oh, we synergized to do this, or, you know, that was win-win because I got, you know, him to share with me, and then we read together. And I had a little boy yesterday that he struggles to read. He's a little bit lower level, even though he's visually impaired. He has some other difficulties with reading. And he offered to help one of my younger BI students to share an AR book and read with her so they could both take an AR test and make points. And I thought that was really, you know, advanced that they're using their habits to help each other and synergize and work together. So I see a big difference as they go on and learn the habits, and they're utilizing them, and they're noticing them, and they're applying them every day. So it's really good.
Thank you. Awesome. Cool. I really enjoy hearing about all the ways that Leader in Me is used in school. Because even though I've read the books and played the game, and I know all the seven habits, and the kids sing me the song, it's really nice as a parent to hear how it's used in the classroom and the rewards that y'all get to see from it. So I think we're pretty much done. I am just going to mention really quickly that this year is my last term as president. So if anybody is interested, we will need a president and a treasurer next year.
And a secretary.
Three of us. So
that scares y'all away.
I could, but I'm not so sure I'd be very good at treasurer or secretary. As we go through the next few months, if you think this is something, I will tell you this. I have a full-time job. I raise two kids, and although I am panicking about symposium, I usually manage to juggle it all pretty well. It's not so big of a burden. It's not a burden at all, but it's not so much work that it gets in the way of the rest of my life.
Well, we appreciate it.
We do appreciate it.
So don't think this is not for you, because it is for somebody. The more somebodies that you have helping you out, the better.
That's right.
And we have a good group to work with, too.
Absolutely. All right, guys. We are done. Call in the meeting. It's 6:30. Ooh. Have time to
Yes. Symposium Friday. Symposium on Friday. Come one, come all. It's the West Fest.